Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. My name is Emily and I make a bunch of videos about Salesforce. Last week on Thursday, we covered the basics of SOQL. Today we're going to be going over my favorite SOQL tool, which is Workbench. There are a few reasons why I absolutely love Workbench. One, it's really easy to edit and create queries. It's great for practicing. It's great for using it in a bunch of different circumstances. In Workbench, you can edit the query, and then you can copy paste it into the data loader, which you cannot edit your query in the data loader. So it's just nice to know that you have it set and ready to go, because man, I would always go back and forth between the data loader if I missed a field or something. It was really annoying. So today we're going to go over showing you how SOQL kind of fits in with the data loader, with the Workbench. So I did already sign in. This is on a practice org. I chose to do a SOQL query, and I chose the opportunity object because it's really easy to show you what I want to show you. So because we already chose the opportunity, we already have our from criteria, and we start off with select. So you select the field from object. So right now I could choose amount from opportunity, but I want to choose name so then I can show you some awesome things. So we already have the first little bit of our SOQL query. I want to show you a filter. So I want to do is one is equal to true. So when I hit query, I see 19 of 19 total records of any records and their names from opportunities where they are close to one. If we were to also select the amount field, we could see that as well. Now this is a great opportunity for me to show you how to sort results. So right now it's kind of in a weird spot where it's not really alphabetized, it's just strewn together. So let's go ahead and sort by the name from A to Z and nulls last. I don't want to restrict it. So what this is going to do is we're going to select name from opportunity where it is closed one and order by name ascending nulls last. So what that's going to do is it's going to go A to Z. Any blanks are going to go last. So let's go ahead and query it and it'll update. Here we go. And it is sorted now by the name. If we went to Z to A, it'll show the list upside down, but not actually upside down, just the other way. So there you go. That is essentially how you use Workbench. Other things that we can do is we can have the nulls first. We could limit this record to 10 records. We could sort it by any different type of fields, even custom fields. If this is a pick list field that you are going to either sort or filter by, you do need to have the pick list name. If we wanted to add another filter, we could do that. Let's see if we could do the amount is over 100,000. Hopefully it does that. Yes, there we go. So it is both closed one and the amount is above 100,000. If we want to do above 10,000, or is equal to, excuse me, not above. Wow, that was very lucky. Do that. There we go. All right, now we have anything that's greater than 1,000. Let's do 100,000 or 10,000, 100,000. Edit it. It's filtering down. So, if we went with the OR statement rather than an AND statement, we could just do OR. And then if either it is close one or it is more than $100,000, it will return it. So some of these might not be close one. Some of them may be close one. Biggest tip for creating a SOQL query is start with your question in mind or what the result is in mind. Let's say someone came to you and they said, I want to see all open opportunities above $10,000. Then what you'd want to do is you would want to create the filters based upon that. And any fields chosen would help you further understand the data that you want to see, because I only have the name, but you have the opportunity to use all the fields on the opportunity object. So, a few other things. This is very similar to the report builder. So sometimes I will start a report out in the report builder, just to gain a grasp of how many records I might see. This does have the ability to do more than the report builder does. So the report builder might cap you at a couple thousand records. This will not cap you at any, I believe, any records. Maybe when you get up into the millions, it might, like the data loader would. So yeah, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, give it a like. Comment any questions you have down below, and I will try and get back to you as fast as possible. And check out my courses. So I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.